Oregon, and I've received via international sign language that we had a little bit of an incident that resulted in losing some of our young worshippers, which is too bad. But nevertheless, it's still story time, and I've still got a story for you, and it's not actually for children. It might seem like it is. This is a story from a great storyteller, Dutch existentialist philosopher Soren Kierkegaard. And I'd like to read it to you. Once upon a time, there was a king who loved a beautiful maiden. This king was like no other king. He was rich and powerful beyond measure. Every statesman trembled before his power. No one dared breathe a word against him, for he had the strength to crush all opponents. And yet this mighty king was melted by love for a humble maiden. Do you all see the maiden in the picture? I want to make sure you're following the story. Who lived in a poor village in his kingdom. How could he declare his love for her? In an odd sort of way, his kingliness tied his hands. And he thought to himself that if he brought her to the palace and crowned her head with jewels and clothed her body in royal robes, surely she would not resist. No one dared resist him. But would she love him? She would say she loved him, of course. But would she truly? Or would she live with him in fear, nursing a private grief for the humble life she left behind? Would she be happy at his side? How could he know for sure? If he rode to her forest cottage in his royal carriage with an armed escort waving bright banners, that would overwhelm her. And this king did not want a craving subject. He wanted a lover, an equal. He wanted her to forget that he was king and she was humble maiden, and to let shared love cross the gulf between them. You see the gulf there? For it is only in love that the unequal can be made equal. What do you think is going to happen next? Anybody? George, Eliza, do you have any ideas? No? George is stumped. Eliza's stumped too. The king, convinced he could not elevate the maiden without crushing her freedom, resolved to descend to her. Clothed as a beggar, he approached her cottage with a warm cloak fluttering loose about him. This was not just a disguise. The king took on a totally new identity. He had renounced his throne. He'd stopped being king to declare his love